బాబు 372 ఎవరమ్మా? 372 18 లేటర్ ఎంట్రీ 372. హలో, ప్లీజ్ రెస్పాండ్. హలో, ప్లీజ్ రెస్పాండ్. 372. హలో, హలో, హలో,
ఎస్ సార్.
బాబు 372ఆ?
302 సార్.
అజాదా?
ఎస్ సార్, ఎస్ సార్.
అదే అదే, ఇది నేను ఇంకా రెండు మూడు క్లాసులు తీసుకుందాం అనుకుంటున్నా, రేడియేషన్ కూడా కంప్లీట్ చేద్దామని, అందుకని పెట్టాను ఇవాడ.
ఓకే సార్.
రేపు కూడా తీసుకుంటా. రేపు టెన్ టు లెవెన్.
ఓకే సార్.
అలాగే మండే ట్యూస్డే నాలుగు క్లాసులు తీసుకుని కంప్లీట్ చేద్దాం.
ఓకే సార్.
మీకు సిఆర్టి క్లాసులో ఉన్నాడు ఎవరు ఉన్నారా?
ఉన్నట్టున్నారు సార్ కొంతమంది.
సర్లే, వాళ్ళు సిఆర్టి కట్టినందుకు మిగతా మిగతా అటెండ్ అవ్వండి.
ఓకే సార్.
రేపు కూడా తీసుకుంటారు? రేపు మన క్లాస్ లేదు కానీ అయినా సాటర్డే తీసుకోండి. నిన్న క్లాస్ పోయింది కదా.
అదే సార్,
నిన్న వర్షమానికి తీసుకోలేదు నిన్న. ఓకేనా?
ఓకే సార్.
రేపు 10 to 11 మార్నింగ్.
ఓకే సార్.
ఇంకా మండే 11 to 12, ట్యూస్డే 11 to 12.
ఓకే సార్.
ఈ నాలుగు క్లాసులు తీసుకుని కంప్లీట్ చేద్దాం రేడియేషన్.
ఓకే సార్.
హలో, ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూ జాయిన్. ఓకే అంటే రేడియేషన్ హీట్ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ లాస్ట్ యూనిట్ సిక్స్త్ యూనిట్ రేడియేషన్ హీట్ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ ఆల్రెడీ ఐ హావ్ కవర్డ్ ద బేసిక్ కాన్సెప్ట్ ఆఫ్ స్టీఫెన్ బోల్ట్జ్మాన్ లా ఇన్ ద స్టార్టింగ్ క్లాసెస్ ఓకే దట్ ఈస్ ఆల్సో కమ్స్ అండర్ రేడియేషన్ సో స్టీఫెన్ బోల్ట్జ్మాన్ లా దట్ ఈ హీట్ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ రేట్ ఇన్ ద రేడియేషన్ హీట్ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ రేట్ ఈక్వేషన్ క్యూ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు సిగ్మా ఏ టీ టు ద పవర్ ఫోర్ వేర్ సిగ్మా ఇస్ ద స్టీఫెన్ బోల్ట్జ్మాన్ కాన్స్టెంట్ 5.67 ఇంటూ 10⁻¹ వాట్ పర్ మీటర్ స్క్వేర్ కే టు ద పవర్ ఫోర్ అండ్ సిగ్మా ఏ సరి ఏరియా ఆఫ్ ది బాడీ ఏరియా ఆఫ్ ది సర్ఫేస్ ఆర్ అదర్వైజ్ టీ అబ్సల్యూట్ టెంపరేచర్ ఓకేనా సో ఇన్ దిస్ రేడియేషన్ హీట్ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ సో యూ హ్యావ్ ఇన్ అవర్ ఫస్ట్ దేర్ ఆర్ ఫోర్ టాపిక్ ఎమిషన్ క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్స్ లాస్ ఆఫ్ బ్లాక్ బాడీ రేడియేషన్ ఇరాడియేషన్ టోటల్ అండ్ మోనోక్రోనిక్ క్వాంటిటీస్ వాట్ ఆర్ దీస్ విల్ డిస్కస్ టుడే ఇన్ దిస్ క్లాస్ విల్ కంప్లీట్ దీస్ ఫోర్ టాపిక్స్ అండ్ ఎమిషన్ క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్స్ మీన్స్ దేర్ ఆర్ వెన్ ఎవర్ ఎ బాడీ ఇఫ్ హీట్ ఎ బాడీ ఇట్ ఎమిట్స్ రేడియేషన్ దట్ ఈస్ సో సమ్ పర్సంటేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇఫ్ ఎనీ రేడియేషన్ ఈస్ reaching the surface of any body some percentage will be absorbed and some percentage will be reflected back and some percentage is transmitted throughout those are known as emission characteristics so black body loss of black body radiation there are different laws like Stefan Boltzmann law what is Kirchhoff's law what is Wien's law like that Planck's law like that there are different laws so generally in this radiation you may get some theory questions as well as problems but theory is you can easily answer so in this class we'll discuss introduction of this emission properties emission characteristics just like what is absorptivity what is reflectivity what is transmittivity that is alpha plus rho plus tau alpha that is absorptivity some reflectivity and transmittivity tau so alpha plus rho plus tau is equal to 1 so here in this so radiation generally radiation exchange already told occurs most effectively in vacuum so there is no medium is required how the sun energy is reaching the earth that is through radiation only so it is passes through radiation transfer passes through vacuum only no medium is required so radiation heat exchange between two bodies depend upon the temperature difference to the fourth power so if the two bodies are radiating with each other one body is emits radiation and second body also emits radiation and how do you calculate radiation heat transfer that Q is equal to sigma a T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4 where T1 is the temperature of one body T2 is the temperature of the second body already given while discussing basics of the radiation in the earlier classes so mainly radiation depends upon temperature difference to the fourth power that is T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4 fourth power of the temperature absolute temperature so that is according to Stefan's law for a black body heat transfer rate Q is equal to sigma a T2 to the power 4 if a single body a single black body sigma a into T2 to the power 4 according to Stefan Boltzmann law heat transfer rate Q is equal to sigma a into T2 to the power 4 where sigma is the Stefan Boltzmann constant a is the surface area T to the power 4 absolute temperature to the power 4 temperature to the power 4 that's why here in this radiation so temperature the heat transfer rate varies with it temperature to the power 4 absolute temperature to the power 4 but convection not like that only temperature difference linear temperature difference here temperature to the power 4 So both the amount of radiation and quality of radiation depend upon the temperature. So what amount of radiation depend upon the temperature. If the temperature is very high, more radiation, more quantity of radiation it transfer. And quality of radiation also high if the temperature is high. So at high absolute temperature level, such as those prevailing furnaces, combustion chambers, nuclear explosions. So furnace emits radiation. If you go to the furnace, you'll get high radiation heat energy. Like that combustion chamber, so emits radiation. Nuclear explosions emits radiation. Like that, number of examples you can go. But how the energy, heat energy reaching from the sun to the earth, that is also through radiation only. Here there are photons are there. In the radiation mechanism, what are the main mechanism? Photons are propagated through space as rays. Photons are propagated, are moving, are transmitted through the space, that is in the vacuum, as rays. The movement of photons is described as electromagnetic waves. So here radiation waves means electromagnetic waves. These electromagnetic waves, whenever reaches the surface, this electromagnetic waves becomes converted into thermal energy. The photons travel in straight paths and straight lines with unchanged frequency when they approach the receiving surface. Whenever these photons reaches the surface of any body, so that photons energy is converted into heat energy. There occurs the reconversion of wave motion into thermal energy. So electromagnetic waves converted into thermal energy. So that energy, thermal energy, which is partly absorbed. If the thermal energy reaches any surface or any body, just like furnace emits energy like that. So if the electromagnetic waves, after converting thermal energy, this thermal energy is partly absorbed. If the thermal energy reaches any surface, so some of the energy, thermal energy is being absorbed by the surface or absorbed by the body. And some of the thermal energy is reflected back. And some percentage of thermal energy is transmitted through the receiving surface. Whenever the photons converted into thermal energy, that energy is partly absorbed, reflected, partly transmitted through the receiving surface. All types of electromagnetic waves are classified in terms of wavelength. So here wavelength is important. What is total energy, or sometimes depends upon at given wavelength, what is the radiation? So electromagnets are propagated at the speed of light. Here photons are electromagnetic waves are moving with the speed of light. See, that is 3×10^8 meters per second. So these radiating rays or electromagnetic waves are moving with the velocity of light, that is 3×10^8. The distinction from one form of radiation and other form lies only in the its frequency and wavelength. So what is the frequency, what is the wavelength, at what wavelength the ray is propagating, at what frequency the ray is moving. So based on your frequency and wavelength, so you can distinguish what type of radiation it is. Infrared radiation or ultraviolet radiation or thermal radiation, like that. Depend upon the frequency and wavelength, what type of radiation it is. Just like what is infrared radiation, what is ultraviolet radiation, what is electromagnetic radiation or thermal radiation. That how do you distinguish with the help of the frequency and wavelength. So the speed of light and the frequency and wavelength are connected with the equation already. All of you know from the basics of physics, speed of the light c is equal to frequency f into wavelength lambda. Frequency f or nf, c is equal to nf, where n is the frequency. Sometimes you are using n, sometimes you are using f, frequency f. That's why c is equal to f into lambda, where f is the frequency, lambda is the wavelength. So the thermal radiation emits between 10 to the power minus 7 meters to 10 to the power minus 4 meters, thermal radiation. So the wavelength values are 10 to the power minus 7 meters, 10 to the power minus 4 meters. In between those, the thermal radiation occurs. So thermal radiation depends upon the nature of the surface, temperature of the surface. For example, is more high temperature, high radiation, like that. Rough nature of the surface, whether it is rough or smooth, polished, and condition of the emitting surface, state or condition of the emitting surface. So radiation heat transfer depends upon the nature of the surface, whether it is rough surface or smooth surface. Depend on temperature. Is low temperature, high temperature. High temperature generally, high temperature more radiation. Like condition of the surface, state or condition. So however, that is with respect to some solids. However, with the gases, they depends also upon the thickness of the emitting layer. Depends upon the layer of thickness. So thickness of the layer, emitting layer, and gas pressure. Depend upon the gas pressure, the radiation energy quantity. So if the gas pressure more radiation energy may be coming out, like that. For any radiation to occur, there are different parameters. What is the nature of the surface? What is the temperature of the surface? What is the condition of the surface? Condition or state of the surface. That's why surface emission property, whenever any surface having some energy, it is having high temperature, it emits radiation. It absorbs radiation, and also at the same time, it emits radiation. Surface emission properties. When a body is at very high temperature, it emits radiation from the surface. That's why whenever from the surface, radiation is coming out, what are those properties, emission properties? The rate of emission of radiation by a body. If any body is at high temperature, at a given temperature, it emits radiation. The rate of emission of radiation, that is rate of heat transfer, depends upon the following factors. These are important, very important. What are that factor that affects the radiation emission or emission of radiation? What are the factors? So the main factor, temperature of the surface and nature of the surface, already told. And sometimes wavelength and frequency of radiation, the rate of heat transfer that is coming from the any surface depends on the wavelength. At what wavelength the radiation is coming, at what frequency the radiation is coming, like that. If wavelength changes, so there may be different radiation energies. Because just like example, ultraviolet radiation, infrared radiation, electromagnetic radiation, thermal radiation, like that. That depends on the wavelength. At any given wavelength, the rate of emission may change from wavelength to wavelength. So wavelength and frequency depends, already given relation. So speed of light is proportional to frequency into wavelength. That's why. So your rate of emission of energy, radiation energy, depends upon the wavelength or frequency of radiation. So parameter which deals with the surface emission properties, you have to read some parameters. What is total emissive power, E, capital E, total emissive power? How do you define this total emissive power? So total emissive power, capital E only. The emissive power is defined as total amount of radiation emitted. What is the energy that is coming out from the, what is radiation energy coming out from the hot body, hot surface, emitted by body, amount of radiation per unit area and per unit time. Per unit area, per unit time is defined as emissive power, total emissive power with capital letter E. It represented with capital letter E, total emissive power. How do you define? It is a radiating amount of radiation emitted by any body per unit area and per unit time. So units are watt per meter square. watt per meter square because per unit area. So for watt per meter square second, for second also sometimes. So generally for a given time, in a given time per unit area, the watt per meter square. The emissive power of a black body is proportional to absolute temperature to the fourth power. So according to Stefan Boltzmann law, the emissive power of a emissive power, the radiating power, that is radiating, emitting radiation, that is coming from any black body, E, capital E, B, B for black body. How do you calculate heat transfer rate or energy emitted by the black body? Sigma T to the power 4, that is absolute temperature to the power T. So where EB, capital EB, the emissive power, total emissive power coming out from the black body, that is equal to sigma into T to the power 4 watt per meter square, where sigma is the Stefan Boltzmann constant. Sigma is equal to Stefan Boltzmann constant, that already given while in the earlier classes, in the starting classes. 5.67 10 power minus 8 watt per meter square K to the power 4. What is the unit here? This sigma unit watt per meter square K to the power 4, because here to the power 4, temperature to the power 4. So for unit area, the radiating energy emitted by the black body is equal to sigma T to the power 4. For a given area of A, for a black body, the radiating energy emitted by the black body, EB, is equal to sigma A into T to the power 4 watts. Watts, total, for total area A. You have to multiply with area A. This is for unit area. This is for total area. So sigma A into T to the power 4. So very, very important. This is absolute temperature only. In the radiation, you are supposed to use absolute temperatures only. Sigma A T to the power 4 watts. So mono, that is the total emissive power. What is a monochromatic emissive power? So that emissive power at a given wavelength is known as monochromatic emissive power. Emissive power emitted by the body at a given wavelength or per unit wavelength is known as monochromatic emissive power. E lambda, capital E lambda, monochromatic emissive power is denoted with E lambda. At any given temperature, the amount of radiation emitted per unit wavelength varies at a different wavelength. At a given wavelength, what is the emissive power, radiation emitted? If the wavelength changes, the amount of radiation emitted also changes. That's why at a given wavelength or per unit wavelength, what is the emissive power? That emissive power is known as E lambda or monochromatic emissive power. So monochromatic emissive power is defined as the rate of energy radiated per unit area of the given surface, per unit area and per unit wavelength. Per unit wavelength, that is important here. Monochromatic wavelength, a monochromatic emissive power with respect to a given wavelength, or at a given wavelength, or per unit wavelength, E lambda. That is monochromatic emissive power is defined as the rate of energy radiated per unit area of the given surface per unit wavelength. Okay, na? That is very, very important. So monochromatic emissive power. So yeah, in the total quantities, monochromatic quantities were given in the first, in the topic here like this. So if you observe, so emissive characteristics, that is absorptivity, reflectivity, transmittivity, that we'll discuss now. Loss of backward radiation, the different laws like Kirchhoff's law, Stefan Boltzmann law, Wien's displacement law, Planck's law, like that. And irradiation, what is total radiation that is received by surface? That is total radiation received by surface is irradiation. And next, total and monochromatic quantities. So here, total quantity, monochromatic quantity. Here, total emissive power. For example, emissive power you take it, that is total value. Total emissive power, that is, so total how much heat energy that is coming at all the wavelength. But here, the in the case of monochromatic emissive power, the emissivity depends upon the given or unit wavelength or given wavelength. That emissive power may change from wavelength to wavelength. That emissive power may change from wavelength to wavelength. That's why this emissive power is known as monochromatic emissive power. E lambda, capital E lambda, is defined as the rate of energy radiated per unit area and per unit wavelength. And one, if you know the emissive power per unit wavelength, that is E lambda, then how do you get total emissive power? Total emissive power can be calculated at different wavelengths. At different wavelengths, wavelength 1, delta 1, lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda like that, lambda 3, like lambda n. If you integrate all those values, you have to get the total emissive power. What is the emissive power at lambda 1? What is the emissive power at the lambda 2? What is the emissive power at the lambda 3? What is the emissive power at the lambda 4? Wavelength. Lambda means wavelength. So if you have to find out the total emissive power, you have to integrate all the values of emissive powers at different wavelengths. At different wavelengths. That's why how do you calculate total emissive power? If you know the emissive power at a given wavelength, that is E lambda. So that is, so total emissive power E, capital E is equal to integral 0 to infinity. That's why lambda varies from 0 to infinity. If you observe that spectrum, wavelength spectrum, your wavelength may vary from 0 to infinity. That's why integral 0 to infinity, E lambda D lambda. Differentiation of lambda with respect to wavelength. So E lambda, monochromatic emissive power at a given lambda. Amount of energy emitted by the surface at a given per unit lambda, per unit wavelength or at a given lambda. That's why total emissive power E is equal to integral 0 to infinity E lambda D lambda watt per meter square.
Hi sir.
Hello. Okay, nah? So emission from real surface. So by black body emission, the emissivity is equal to 100% emission. But for real surface, the emissivity is always less than 1.
My sir.
So emission from real surface, so black body, so 100% emission, but that is compare, you have to compare any real surface with the black body surface. So emission from the black body 100%. So from the real surface, so you have to compare the real surface with the black surface with the term emissivity. So that why for the black body, total emission E is equal to sigma 8 e to the power 4 watts. Total emissive power from a black body, sigma 8 e to the power 4. But if you take the real surface, so you have to take the emissivity into consideration, emissivity epsilon. You have to consider the emissivity epsilon.
A chapter, sir?
Radiation, amma. 6th unit.
Okay, sir.
ఇప్పుడే జాయిన్ అయ్యా నువ్వు మరి అందుకనే స్టార్టింగ్ పెట్టాను కదా ఇప్పుడు
ఇప్పుడే చూసాను సార్
ఓకే ఓకే పర్లేదులే ఇంకా స్టార్టింగ్ లో ఉన్నాంలే
ఓకే సార్
రేడియేషన్ హీట్ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ లాస్ట్ యూనిట్ ఓకేనా లాస్ట్ యూనిట్ రేడియేషన్ హీట్ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్
యూనిట్ సార్
last unit 6th unit last unit.
Okay sir.
So far we completed 5 units. Okay na, heat exchanger 5th unit heat exchanger, next boiling and condensation we completed
first unit sir.
Hello, Now last unit, radiation heat transfer.
Last line first, sir.
Hello? Emba wait ma.
16 units, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay, clear,
huh? All clear, sir. Head and shoulder.
Okay, last unit. This is the last unit. I will take 4 or 5 classes. I will complete. Okay, na?
You will take 7 or 8, sir.
Pardon me? Okay. So, this is the radiation heat transfer. So, here total emissive power. Capital E. So total emissive power depends on the total amount of radiation emitted by body per unit area and unit time, watt per meter square. And for black body, total emissive power sigma T to the power 4 according to Stefan Boltzmann law, where sigma is the Stefan Boltzmann constant, T capital is the absolute temperature to the power 4 radiation, the temperature to the power 4 only. And monochromatic emissive power, so it depends upon the wavelength. So in this given spectrum, if the wavelength changes, your MC power also change at a given wavelength. That's why monochromatic MC power is defined as the rate of energy radiated per unit area of the surface per unit wavelength. So total MC power is given by, so integral 0 to infinity E lambda D lambda, where E lambda is the monochromatic emissive power. Okay, with respect to D lambda, we are integrating. Our limits are here in the given spectrum, this electromagnetic spectrum, the your wavelength may change from 0 to infinity. So emission from real surface. So real surface emissivity, with respect to emissivity. So emissivity is equal to emissivity of the real surface divided by emissivity of the, okay, emissivity is equal to MC power of the real surface divided by MC power of the black body. From that, MC power of the real surface is equal to emissivity epsilon. You can represent emissivity with epsilon. That's why epsilon into, so MC power of the black body. But how do you call MC power of the black body? Sigma A T to the power 4. That's why MC power from a real surface, any given surface, is equal to emissivity epsilon. This is emissivity of the material epsilon into emissive power of the black body, that is sigma A T to the power 4. That's why emissive power of any given real surface is equal to emissivity into emissive power of the black body. But how do you call emissive power of the black body? Sigma A T to the power 4. Here capital E, emissive power of the real surface. Epsilon, this is epsilon. Epsilon is the emissivity of the material. Sigma, what is sigma? Stefan Boltzmann constant. A, area of the given surface. T, absolute temperature to the power 4. So where emissivity is defined as the ratio of the, how do you define emissivity? Epsilon is equal to emissivity is defined as the ratio of the emissive power of any body or any real surface. MC power of any given body to the MC power of the black body, or MC power of any given surface to the MC power of the black surface of equal temperature. So sometimes if the MC real surface at given temperature and also at the same temperature of the black body, if you compare real body with the black body at same temperature, then emissivity epsilon is equal to MC power of the real surface divided by MC power of the black surface, or MC power of the any body, any given real body, MC power of the capital E by capital EB, MC power of the given body to the MC power of the black body. So emissivity will range from 0 to 1. For a black body, emissivity is equal to 1, epsilon. Epsilon varies from 0 to 1, or emissivity varies from 0 to 1. For a black body, epsilon, emissivity is equal to 1. For a white body, so white body, what is the function? White body? White body is completely reflected. That's why emissivity is 0. For gray body, the emissivity will be 0 to 1. ओके ना. सो नेक्स्ट ये emission characteristics are parameters. So these are four important parameters. One is total MC power, second one is monochromatic MC power, third one is emission from the real surface, fourth one intensity of, what is the intensity of radiation, intensity in terms of Q, radiation energy, how much energy, intensity of radiation. These are the important parameters that affects the radiation heat transfer. So here, whenever the incident radiation G, capital G, so irradiation means what is the total amount of energy that is incidenting on any surface. This is a material surface. So the energy, for example, energy from the sun is reaching the this material, this surface. That is known as incident radiation. What is the amount of radiation that is incidenting or reaching the material surface? That is represented with G. This is known as irradiation. Irradiation, total amount of energy that is reaching the material surface is known as irradiation. It is represented with capital letter G. Out of this incident radiation that is reaching the material surface, some of the radiation is reflected back. That is reflected radiation. That is represented with GR, R for reflection. And some of the energy is absorbed in the material. That is an absorbed radiation, GA, A for absorption. Okay. Evrama, raise hand. Who has a raise hand? Hello. What is your doubt? Data book will be supplied in the exams, but not internal exams, external exams. You have to purchase for the internal exams. You have to take the data book. You have to purchase and you have to bring the data book to the internal exams. But for external exams, they will supply. Okay, na? Okay. Next, the incident radiation from the, that is known as irradiation. Generally, convection, boiling, and condensation. Okay, mainly convection. So mainly in the convection you require data book. Boiling condensation, so light requirement for boiling condensation, steam tables. So there are total six units. For all the chapters of convection, you require, sometimes in the problem you may give some data, but sometimes you have to note down the data from the data book. Okay, incident radiation, some energy is reflected back, some energy is absorbed. The absorbed radiation is GA, reflected is GR, and some energy is transmitted through this thickness. Transmitted, just like a glass, any glass. So transmitted radiation. So transmitted radiation is GT. Okay, now out of this incident radiation, that is G, capital G, that is, we can call it as irradiation. Total amount of radiation that incidents are reaching the surface, you know, irradiation, that is incident radiation capital G. Out of G, some percentage reflected back, that is not reflected radiation. Some percentage absorbed, that is not absorbed radiation. So some percentage is transmitted, that is known as transmitted radiations. So reflected radiation represents GR, capital GR. So absorbed radiation represents capital GA. Transmitted radiation is represented with capital GT, small t. When the incident radiation G is also called irradiation, irradiation. So what is irradiation? Total amount of radiation that is reaching the surface. Total amount of radiation energy reaching the surface is known as irradiation. That is incident radiation are also called irradiation. Irradiation defined as the total incident radiation on any surface from all the directions. From all the directions, what is the amount of radiation that is reaching the surface? That is known as irradiation or incident radiation. All the directions for unit time and for unit area of the surface. Expressed in watt per meter square. Irradiation expressed in watt per meter square. And denoted by G, capital G. Denoted by capital G. Impinges on any surface. Here. Impinges or reaching any surface. Three things happen. What are the three things in one? Some percentage reflected back. Some percentage absorbed. Some percentage transmitted. That is, those are the three things. A part of the incident radiation is reflected back, that is GR. A part of the incident radiation is transmitted through, that is GT. And the remainder is, remainder energy, some percent reflected back, some percentage transmitted through. What about remaining? The remaining energy is absorbed by the material. Absorbed by the material, that is GA. So that that depends upon this amount of incident radiation, how much amount is reflected, how much is transmitted, how much amount is absorbed, depend upon the characteristics of the given body. Characteristics of the given body as shown in this here, how the reflected back, how it is absorbed, how it is transmitted, we are showing on with the help of this diagram. So by the conservation of energy principle, what is the conservation of energy principle? What is the amount of energy that is reaching the surface, that is irradiation, amount of incident radiation, how much energy that will G is equal to GR plus GA plus GT. That is known as energy conservation principle. Energy conservation principle. That is, by the conservation of energy principle, what is our equation? Energy absorbed plus energy reflected plus energy transmitted through the given material, or through the given surface is equal to total capital G, that is total incident radiation or irradiation. Incident radiation, this one, incident radiation capital G. That is equal to, G is equal to GR plus GA plus GT. That is from the energy principle, conservation of energy. What is the amount of energy that is input? That energy is coming out as absorbed energy, reflected energy, and transmitted energy. That's why radiation energy, how much energy that is incidenting on any surface, that is some percentage is reflected back, some percentage is transmitted through the material, and the remaining energy is absorbed by the given material. Remaining energy is absorbed by the given material. So dividing both sides by G, dividing left hand, this is left hand side, this is right hand side. Dividing both sides by capital G, that is incident radiation, we get GA by capital G plus GR by capital G plus GT by capital G is equal to capital G by capital, that is one. Capital G by capital, that is one. That's why GA by G, amount of energy absorbed by the given material to the total energy incidented or incident radiation, that is known as alpha. Absorptivity is represented with the letter alpha, and reflectivity is represented with the Greek letter rho. So amount of energy reflected back to the total incident energy, GR by capital G, that is reflectivity, plus GT by capital G, transmittivity, amount of energy transmitted through the material to the incident radiation, GT by capital G, the transmittivity, tau. That's why alpha plus rho plus tau is equal to 1. From the energy principle, energy conservation principle, so GA by G plus, GR by G plus, GT by G plus is equal to G by G, 1. That's why, so absorptivity plus reflectivity plus transmittivity is equal to 1, where alpha is the absorptivity, rho is the reflectivity, tau is the transmittivity. So how do you define the absorptivity? Amount of energy absorbed by the given surface to the total amount of energy, total incident energy, rather, total incident energy or irradiation, that is known as absorptivity. And similarly, reflectivity, GR by G, and transmittivity, GT by G, where GT is the amount of energy transmitted through the material by to the total irradiation or to the total incident energy, that is transmittivity. So these three are very important characteristics of any radiating surface, important characteristics of any radiation surface, emission characteristics. Absorptivity, reflectivity, transmittivity. Okay, na? When the incident radiation is absorbed, it is converted into internal energy. So, what is the amount of energy that is absorbed by the material? It is converted into internal energy. It's the internal energy of the material increases. Here, there are different bodies like black body, opaque body, white body, gray body, like that. So today we'll discuss what is black body, what is opaque body. So these are from the physics, you have already know what is a black body, what is opaque body. What is a black body? It is a perfectly absorbing body. Black body is one which is a perfectly absorbing body. That's why absorptivity is equal to 1, alpha absorptivity is equal to 1. Here reflectivity 0, transmittivity 0. Absorptivity is equal to 1. Alpha is equal to 1. Rho is equal to 0. Tau is equal to 0. So the black body can define like this. It is a body which absorbs all the instant energy. That is, absorbed alpha is equal to 1. Reflected rho is equal to 0. Transmitted tau is equal to 0. Such body is called a black body. But in practice, a perfect block, in practice, there is no black body that exists. That's why in practice, a perfect black body does not exist. However, its concept is very important for comparison with any other given bodies. But so you have to any gray body, any other body, any practical body. So those bodies are to be compared with black body in the radiation. That is very, very important concept. Because your emissivity, you're comparing with emissivity of any body, you're comparing with black body. That's why MCT is equal to MCT of the given body to the MCT of the black body. That's why, so black body concept is very, very important. What is black body? If the complete absorptivity is completely 100%, that is alpha is equal to 1. And so the reflected 0, transmitted 0. That body is known as that is black body. What is opaque body? So when no incident radiation is transmitted, that transmission is 0. If there is no transmission through the material, no incident radiation transmitted to the material all through the body, it is called an opaque body. That is, the opaque body, transmitted tau is equal to 0. So we are having the relation alpha plus rho plus tau is equal to 1. But if transmitted tau is equal to 0, then alpha plus rho is equal to 1. When no incident radiation is transmitted through the body, that is transmitted 0, that body is known as opaque body. For opaque body, transmitted is equal to 0. That's why therefore alpha plus rho plus tau is equal to 1. This is tau is equal to 0 here. That's why alpha plus rho is equal to 1. Here equation for opaque body, alpha plus rho is equal to 1. Here absorptivity is there, then reflectivity is there, but transmittivity is 0. Okay, na? So that's all for today. These are basics of radiation heat transfer. So tomorrow we'll continue. Tomorrow also I'm giving the extra class from 10 to 11. Tomorrow 10 to 11 extra class. All of you listen very carefully. Tomorrow extra class 10 to 11. Okay, today, okay, because I have some other work also. Tomorrow, we'll see. So, here, so these are basic concepts of radiation. So, remaining concept we'll see tomorrow. Tomorrow, if possible, we'll continue tomorrow. Tomorrow, 10 to 11, extra class. That's all for today. So somebody asked me to continue, but today I have some other work, some MBA work. That's why I could not able to continue. Tomorrow, we'll see. So that's all for today. I'm stopping. Any doubt?